Hi guys, and welcome again to my channel. In the last episode, I spoke about phasing out the project and why it should be done. Whilst phasing it, it will help you improve on your cash flow, and that's what you want. So you avoid a bank liability by taking a loan, using your buyer's money by selling off plan, meaning that your clients will pay ahead of the house being delivered. I went into detail with those. On this episode, I want to talk about the dredging that was done here. When I came into here, I have never had any experience in dredging. But one thing that a good entrepreneur should do is always ready to learn. And I was ready to learn. My first contact on dredging was a banker that I met at Asso Savings and Loans, who was supposed to be one of our bankers. So he had worked for another bank before that and had a portfolio in dredging. So he asked me that he was interested, together with his partner, to take up the contract for dredging. And the quantity that was worked out, we were looking at about 800,000 cubic meters of sand. Initially it was 650,000 cubic meters, but later we had to sand fill close to 800,000 cubic meters of sand. So whilst negotiating with him, there was another party that came in who were also interested in dredging, and we had a relationship with them. So they were all young. So what I did to start with is that, look, there's enough for everybody. Why don't the two of you work together? So that's a lesson to learn. And partnerships should be formed, because some volumes, the volume of some projects, you know, is so big that everybody can walk away being very happy. So I got them to set up a joint venture, and they worked together, and we contracted out to them to do the dredging. Now, in doing the dredging, we had a tributary, a river, that was very close to the site. So first, they do a sand search. There are experts who will do this. And then there's also an EIA, an environment impact assessment. So environmentalists are very concerned about, you know, dredging and what you do and the effect it has on the environment. So we did all this, submitted it to the environment department, and they gave us approval. And then we contracted out to these parties, this joint venture. They did a sand search, which is very technical, you know, searching out the sand that is at the underside of the river. So quantities were all worked out, and then they contracted out a machine, which is the dredging machine, the dredger. It's like a boat that will do the dredging. So they started doing the dredging, and in doing so, you have to have ways of measuring it, where to spread it and compact it. But whilst doing this also, you'll have some challenges. One of the main challenges you have, again, is the community. Because the community wants to be part of everything that is being done. So the different expertise were used in this group. One of them was very technical, who understood dredging. So he was on the boat, you know, he was handling the dredging part. And then the other handled finance. You know, so he was the one who worked with us and the banks in raising the finance. Then the other dealt with community issues, you know, spoke to the community, made sure that they were happy and the dredging couldn't be stopped. So this was done, and a lot of equipment needed to be hired, you know, bulldozers, shovels, you know, compactors, because when you dredge, you need to compact them in layers. And then you need to give it time for it to spread, you know, compact it. Then you do geotechnical studies. So we had to bring in geotechnical experts who will drill boreholes, you know, to certify that the ground was strong enough to take the foundations. This was all done, and then the design was done for the foundations. And the design for the foundations were mainly raft. A raft coming from the word raft, you know, when you have a raft floating on water, what happens, it doesn't sink. So the foundation you know, were very massive, and it was a raft foundation. Being that the ground was so poor and sand-filled, a raft foundation was done, very well reinforced. And because of that, then we now had to look at the sort of structures that we are going to use. So the structures that were used were not ordinary structures, and I will talk about that in the next episode. We used special structures for the apartments, and we definitely had the foundations very designed to able to take those structures. So guys, that's all for the dredging. If you're working in this area, you need to be aware that you cannot easily come about land, so a lot of dredging needs to be done. You need to get some sand from the underside of the water, pump it in, compact it, do all the necessary engineering. But we are happy that this team that we formed continued working together as a joint venture, and they were mainly very young Nigerians. So this is one lesson you need to understand and learn, that always encourage people to work together. Whatever one can do, two can do it better. So I would like to advise those young ones that are watching us, always try to form partnership, because you have an input, you have a strength that you can bring in, others can bring in something different, and you can grow bigger. So on that note, please don't forget to do the right thing by pressing the subscribe button and the like button, and then I'll see you in the next episode. Thank you.